This is Lean Discovery sitting with the C-suite. I'm Clinton Sanko with Baker Donaldson, and today my guest is Joan Davison of Higher Counsel and Mestel & Company. If you were sitting down with a general counsel that was responsible for a litigation portfolio or an e-discovery portfolio within a company, and they were to ask you, you know, Joan, how do I measure the effectiveness of my overall staffing strategy within an e-discovery document review portfolio, what are the key ROIs that I should be measuring? What would be your answer as to what they should be chiefly looking at in terms of measuring that value that's brought?
Yeah, so I think it's a two-part. If you're dancing, it's a Texas two-step? Not that I'm from Texas. But the first step of that is just getting the core basic scorecard down. And that's round one, right? What is the cost structure? What is how many documents are being reviewed? What's the quality percentages? What was the budget? Is it on budget? Is it under budget? Right. So it's the most generalized scorecard. But for repeat general counsel that are going to have ongoing litigations, it's taking that scorecard that you've baselined on your first two or three or four projects, and then asking the vendor community, not just us, but the whole vendor community, what have we learned? What should we be applying? And that means to me, to our organization, what have we learned through this process? What can we adjust in the workflow? What can we adjust in the reviewers that are doing it? What project managers have been most successful? What are we hearing and learning to make the next project more cost effective? But the other area of it is, what have we learned to bring back to the organization to make my organization stronger? So we all seem to think about, you know, the litigation as a case and a matter, and we got to get through it, and we got to be on budget, and we got to hit these deadlines and hit these ratios and get it to the court on time and make it defendable and all of these, and all that's the given. But after one or two, the general counsel really now needs to start to say, what are the similarities and what education do I bring back to my company? You know, where did we fall? What is the consistency that we're seeing that we're either getting caught up on or that we have to overcome? And how do I take that internally and bring it to my training department and do something with it as a company, as a corporation, as opposed to in my little arena of just legal? So I think if I was speaking to the GC, it is creating that scorecard and that dashboard of your standard KPIs, many of them which we all share, measuring it, but then making sure that really very quickly after that, it becomes a broader conversation of what can we learn, how do we bring it back and take it back into the organization. I think for the general counsel, for general counsel to have a broader footprint in an organization, I think sharing these learnings and these opportunities with the rest of the company really starts to set the different companies apart.